Joining me is Reince Priebus. He is chairman of the Republican National Committee. I believe you're in Wisconsin this morning, so thanks for getting up a bit early to talk to us, Reince. I'm assuming that you've heard a little bit of the conversation that preceded you while we got your satellite working. So talk to me about the influence you think the continuation of the implementation of Obamacare is going to have on the 2014 elections. I don't know if you heard Congressman Clyburn saying, you're darn right Democrats are going to campaign on it because folks like it.
Well, I mean, I think it's pretty clear that when you have over 30 Democrats voting against the president on funding Obamacare, that the real division in any party is on the Democratic side of the aisle. Yet, you know, the news media wants to talk about, you know, the Republicans debating a tactic as opposed to the fact that you've got the most vulnerable the most vulnerable Democrats that are running for Senate and the House that are saying, hey, listen, we want to wipe our hands clean of this Obamacare bill that's a total train wreck. And that's their words, not ours, although we would join in on that chorus. So I think it's pretty clear. I think it's the tactic that the president is using in delaying the employer's side is all about getting some Democrats reelected in 2014. And I think it's very obvious that it isn't a law that people like. I'm in Racine, Wisconsin, and I live in Kenosha, Wisconsin. These are mostly middle-class families that see Obamacare as something that's very bad for their families and their futures.
On the other hand, you do have the things that Congressman Clyburn talked about that Republicans say there are four, which is no lifetime limits on health care payback from insurance companies, keeping your adult children on your health care until they're 26, no such thing as pre-existing conditions. If the Republicans position themselves as some senators have and certainly some congressmen have, that no matter what, Obamacare has to be defunded, that is, not implemented, does that not put you all in a place where you have to argue, why are you against all these good things? Because you saw the president, and that's exactly what he'll do.
Right, but Candy, you're picking out three things out of a bill that lists, 5,000. I mean,
right, but they're kind of the most important things to a lot of people.
No, they're not. But the Republicans had many of those provisions in their bill. I mean, when we ran in November, we were talking about pre-existing conditions, kids that were 26 on their parents' plans. I mean, this isn't like some Democratic exclusive or something. I mean, the fact is, what people don't want are government panels deciding whether something's medically necessary. They don't want a government panel deciding that their doctor, instead of getting, a quarter for every dollar of service, they're going to say, well, now you're going to get a nickel. Well, then guess what? I'm not taking that patient. People know what Obamacare is. I mean, it's European socialist-style type health care, and people don't want it. I mean, the real story here is that the Democrats in the Senate and the House, the ones that are vulnerable and want to get reelected, have turned their back on the president. That's the story, not the tactics on the Republican side of the aisle. People don't want this. If this was such a great idea, then all of these senators that are vulnerable in 2014 would have voted for it, and they didn't. And so that should tell you everything you want to know. The cynical part of me says keep it in place so that we can run even more on Obamacare in 2014.
Nonetheless, there are divides.